Hello everyone! In this first video, you will learn how to set up the Harmony development environment for applications using microchip devices. This video is based on Chapter 1 in my book, Learn Harmony V3 for PIC32MZ, available at... In case you did not know this, all of the development software is free for download from the microchip website. All of the examples in this book and the video use an inexpensive development board available from Microchip Direct. If you like this video and want to see more, hit the subscribe button on the screen. So let's get started. First, we want to download and install the MPLAB X IDE. That goes to that page and scroll down and find the one for your computer. In our case, this is on a Mac, so that's the one I'm going to choose. And there it is. MPLAB X version 6.0. And it's going to be 25 minutes left, so it'll take a while. So we'll just pause and come back to it. Okay, now that we've downloaded the MPLAB X application, it goes to the Downloads folder, go there, double-click on it. Yes. Start that one. And it eventually will start here. It's a large file. There we go. Accept. Notice it goes to the microchip directly, microchip directory, and it'll create MPLAB X V6.00. You can use your judgment whether you want those. We'll just go on. We want those two. We don't want 8-bit, 16-bit, or other MCUs. Let's go on. Okay. And now we'll just start the install. This takes a fair amount of time, well, relatively. So we'll just let it cook for a while, come back to it when it's done. Okay, now it's the install is completed. We'll launch it just to be sure that it's working properly. We won't check any of the other things. We're going to do those ourselves later. So finish. Close this one up. And it will start up. And there we've done it. MPLAB X IDE V6.00. Get out of that. Now go to Applications, which is where it now resides, the executable resides under Microchip, MPLAB X V6.00, and there's the app file for both the IDE and IPE. IDE is the one we'll work with. IPE allows you to program the thing without going through the whole big compile routine. Assumes you already have a X file ready to download. So we may get to that at the end of one of the later videos. But for now, we'll just put these on the desktop. Let's see those show up. There they are. They're just aliases. So that's it. I think we've done it. It's all installed, ready to be used. So let's go to the next step, which is to get the compiler. So we can install that one. And again, view the downloads. And again, look for Mac X32. There we go. and it, version 4.00 is now being downloaded. This one's a little shorter. It's only going to take about 10, 14 minutes, so we'll come back to this when the download's complete. All right, it's complete. Let's get out of that one and go to the downloads folder. There we are, XE32. Double click that. And start the install. Okay, double click that. It's okay. We're going to install this in the same directory as the under the microchip directory that we just created in the MPLAB X. Accept the agreement. The free version, yes. See, it's going to be installed at application's microchip. It'll create an XE32 subdirectory and then version 4.0. That's good. Share, add that. Next. All right. And this is installing. Let that go and come back to it. Okay. Don't know if that is for the free version. We don't need any of that. Okay. All right, so we've got that. Well, now the only thing left is Harmony itself, which comes as a plugin, so we have to create our own directory. So let's go over here to Applications, Microchip. Notice here's MPLAB X, XE32, and that Microchip directory. And we go there, double click on that. Go up, new folder. And it'll be called Harmony. All right, so there under Microchip, we have our main components here, MPLAB X, compiler, communications library, and Harmony. So we're all set for as far as Microchip stuff goes. So let's go to the next. Okay, now that we have a place to put all the Harmony components, we'll open MPLAB X, get the download, and install it. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's open up the MPLAB X. Go to Tools, Plugins Download, Plugin Manager, and look for MPLAB Harmony 3 Launcher. Install that. Accept the terms, install it. Now the next step will be to use this to then download the, I'm going to restart. Now we'll download all the different packages that we need. So we'll wait for the MPLAB X to restart. Now we'll go back up to Tools. Notice this time there's a lot more tools embedded. Harmony 3 Content Manager. That's the right path that we chose. Next. All right, now this is the content manager screen. First as a connection test to the GitHub directory. So we're in the remote packages now, and there's a whole list of them. I'll just scroll down, and you can see this is a lot, very difficult to understand. But luckily, to start out with, all we need is MHC, which has already been checked, DevPax, CSP, and we want core, so we'll scroll down here and do core. And we could download now, but let's view and accept all the licenses because this is a pain. You just have to do it, so accept all licenses and just start clicking next until we're out of accepting all the licenses. Close that. Okay, we've accepted all the licenses. And let's go back up to the top and start the downloads. Okay. You see it starts up pretty quickly and then just bogs down. It'll take a long time. This could take over a half an hour. These three are already going simultaneously, and down here in core. Get that one started too. There's the dependencies, and says don't automatically mark them now. We'll take care of them later, so cancel that, and the core will start. It gets about halfway done, and then just bogs down. So what we're going to do now is take a break and come back to this. About finished with the downloads. Notice all the remote packages. None of them that we downloaded appear here because they're now in the local packages. Quick Docs, MHC, Core, DevPacks, and the CSP. To see where they show up in our computer, we go to the microchip. Applications, Microchip, Harmony, V3, and that's where they all go. So when we download other packages later on, this is where they'll show up using the same procedure. And so that's where we're headed in this one. So we'll get rid of all of this. And okay, now that the Harmony repositories are downloaded. One last thing we have to do is get the application source code, which is also in the GitHub repository or area. So go to GitHub, go to the PIC32MZ downloads, click on the green code button, download the zip file. See, there it is. And now we'll go to okay, so the download goes to the downloads folder, and the name is PIC32MZ Downloads Master Zip. Okay, so what we want to do is move that to, let's copy that, and move it over to where we want it, which is in the Harmony directory. It's going to go under that level, Harmony. So let's paste the item, open it. We don't have to do anything more. All right, so we've extracted everything. It's into this file called MZ downloads master learn HTC figures readme. Okay, so this is the file that contains all the source code for the examples. All right, so I think we're ready to configure the hardware. Hey, in this video,
I'll show you how easy it is to hook up the Microchip Curiosity 2.0 prototype board to the laptop containing all the Harmony software for a complete, inexpensive development environment. So let's look at the Curiosity board. It's got a daughter board with Ethernet, two USB ports, one for debug, one for the application, four LEDs, and four switches, and a reset switch. Also, two microbus slots here for third-party plug-in boards, but we're not going to be using those in this book. I'm using a Mac laptop for these videos, but Harmony works just fine on a PC laptop also. So now all we have to do, we just connect up the USB port, the two USB ports, and the Ethernet port, and we hook that to a cable, a hub, right? Because the laptop doesn't have enough USB slots. And then we just plug that hub into the laptop, and boom, the board is powered on from the USB. No need for an additional power supply, even though you could use a powered USB. That's it. That's all that's needed to develop and test the examples in the book. USB CDC dual port example, HTTP, HTTPS, TCP/IP, and FreeRTOS.
If you have been following along on your own computer, you should now have a complete development environment for programming Microchip 32-bit devices. There are more resources available online. I've listed a few of them on the screen that may be helpful during your learning process. None of these are necessary for the book or the videos. In the next video, I will show you how to configure the hardware and software and how to create a complete Harmony V3 project that will compile, load, and execute. Thanks for watching, and remember to hit the subscribe button. I'll see you in video number 2.